got milk? Not anymore. Everything is going just as I planned. Soon the entire world will be without dairy milk. No butter on toast, no ice cream, no cheddar cheese, and nothing but dry cereal. Nothing can stop me now.
Somewhere over the Mediterranean Sea.
Would you like our Italian entree, sir?
No, thanks. It gives me hives.
Our vegetarian dinner, then?
Nope. Gives me the vapors.
Then may I recommend the Greek plate? It's delicious.
All right, if you insist.
Enjoy. It's good to see you, Agent Fox.
Ah, Monkey Penny. Now this is a real TV dinner.
Right.
Yesterday, our spy operatives discovered the factories and offices of Amalgamated Moo Juice Incorporated abandoned and drained of milk. Soon, the entire world's remaining milk reserves will be depleted.
The idea of eating dry breakfast cereal is pretty hard to swallow.
Yes, it is. Here's the only clue we have.
Feta cheese. A low grade, too.
Spy operatives took that picture in the office of Mr. Howard Hugh Heifer Udderly III.
President and CEO of Amalgamated Moo Juice Incorporated.
Exactly. We presume he has valuable information on the dairy crisis. The only available picture of him is hidden in your mashed potatoes. Finding Udderly is your top priority.
He shouldn't be hard to spot.
The feta cheese samples found in Udderly's office have been traced back to the island of Acidophilus. Your plane will be flying over the island any minute now. I've already set up the mobile command center where you'll rendezvous with me and later on with Quack. The entrance code is in your fortune cookie. Any questions?
No, I'm on my way.
Good. Monkey Penny, out.
I wish I hadn't left my parachute in my other tuxedo. Maybe one of my special spy gadgets will help me. I wonder which one I should pick. So that's where I left my anvil. A bit weighty for me. I'm in no mood to tickle the ivories now. That was impressive. You should have seen the one that got away. So this is the sleepy little Greek island of Acidophilus. I seem to have arrived unfashionably early, since nothing seems to be open. I should meet up with Monkey Penny at the Mobile Command Center.
Hey, wanna see my tattoo?
Your mother must be so proud.
Wanna see my tattoo?
Ahoy, matey.
Oh,
555-1394. How fortunate that Monkey Penny gave me this entrance code.
Hello, Bicor Mobile Command Center.
Penny, I've got your number. Now that's a person-to-person phone call.
Glad you could drop in, Spycock.
Hello, Monkey.
That's Monkey Penny. So what do you think of SkyCorp's new Greek Island Mobile Command Center?
Impressive. Disguising it as a half-ferry boat in the middle of the town square was a stroke of genius. Nobody would ever notice that.
That was Professor Quack's idea.
Where is Quack?
Oh, he'll be here soon to refill the Spy Gadget vending machine. In the meantime, he sent a couple of things ahead for your mission.
Good, because a spy without a gadget is like a shopping cart without a broken wheel.
How apt. Now pay attention. This is Greek money. It's called drachmas. You may need to buy a few things around here on the island. And this is a
toothbrush. And I sure could use one after that airplane meal.
Don't put that in your mouth. It's not a regular toothbrush. It's a special laser toothbrush. Let me show you how it works. You hold the laser toothbrush, apply the minty fresh laser gel, push the button, then you can use it to cut through really thick steel.
I guess that's one way to fight cavities. So, do we have any idea where Mr. Udderly is being held?
No solid evidence yet, but you might want to check out that feta factory down by the docks.
Feta factory, huh? I thought I smelled something suspicious. I sure wish Quack would get here so I could get some more of those nifty spy gadgets. You know, some people say life is like an empty vending machine. You put in your quarter and all you get is a whole lot of nothing.
Gee, you're in a depressing mood today, aren't you? Don't you have better things to do than to fiddle around with an empty vending machine?
My spy watch is beeping. Spy Fox to Mobile Command Center.
Please stand by.
Spy Fox here.
Hi, Spy Fox. Remember, you can call me via your spy watch anytime for help and information. Just press the mobile command button.
Will do. Spy Fox, out. Ah, the Mediterranean Sea. Too bad there isn't a boat for me to rent for a little cruise around the island. N-O-G. If I'm not mistaken, and I rarely am, that stands for Nectar of the Goats, a world-renowned purveyor of goat milk and goat byproducts. It says Feta Factory. Uh-oh. Normally, I would karate chop my way right through a door. But this one seems to be made of solid steel. The laser toothbrush makes impervious steel doors pervious. Now that's a big side of beef. No buts about it. That's Mr. Udderly, all right. And he's dangling over a pool of piranha. Now the question is, how am I going to get his rump roast down from there? Piranha. I wonder what a South American fish that can eat creatures alive has to do with making cheese. I have a feeling this is no ordinary feta factory. Maybe that lever will help me get Mr. Udderly's rump roast down from there. That's not going to work. Piranhas can skeletonize a cow in a matter of minutes. This must be the temperature control for this pool of cars. Kind of an odd fixture for a feta cheese factory. The piranha pool seems to be getting colder. The little beasties seem to be slowing down. Fish on ice. That should hold them. Now for Mr. Udderly.
You saved me! Thank you, Mr.
Fox. Spy, Fox. Routine rescue, really? Now I need to get you to our mobile command center for a debriefing.
Good! I need to change my pants.
You've got to stop him, Mr. Fox!
All right, just calm down, Mr. Udderly. Why don't you start from the beginning and tell us what happened?
Well, it all started as a typical day at the office. When you're as important as I am, you're constantly fielding international cattle calls and reviewing grazing reports.
Yep, you have to stay pretty sharp in the dairy biz. So, when William the Kid Thugs made their appearance, I immediately snapped into action.
There were dozens of them. I fought them hoof and nail.
Pow, 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 I did.
My whole body's a weapon.
Then suddenly, I smelled something revolting.
It could only be one thing.
Feta cheese!
Cheese! The stink was so overwhelming that I nearly passed out. Taking advantage of my momentary asphyxiation, kidnappers jumped me and then forced me into a smelly dark bag.
They whisked me away to Kid Secret Island Fortress.
It was just so humiliating being bagged up like a piece of beef.
But were you able to learn anything about what William the Kid is up to?
Well, thanks to a little bovine ingenuity on my part, I picked a few things up.
Kid's demented scheme for gaining worldwide domination is run by a front company called Nectar of the Goats Corporation. He has a five-part master plan. First, capture all the dairy cows in the world. As you know, he's already done that. Second, he built that milky weapon of destruction inside his secret fortress. Third, use this milky weapon of destruction to flood the capital with none too fresh dairy milk. Fourth, frame all the poor dairy cows for this heinous crime. Fifth, take over the entire dairy world. Hi, Fox. Someone needs to find that secret fortress and disarm that milky weapon of destruction.
Sounds challenging. I need to find that secret fortress and disarm that milky weapon of destruction.
Oh, I almost forgot. When William the Kid's back was turned, I swiped the secret code that turns the milky weapon of destruction off.
Good going. Where is it?
Well, I had to swallow the code before I could read it so it wouldn't be discovered. Can you believe it?
I find the whole thing a little hard to swallow. We need to figure out a way to get a look at that code. Someone needs to find that secret fortress and stop William the Kid.
Good morning, Spy Fox. I took the liberty of loading the vending machine with some of my ingenious new spy gadgets. You should take a look at some of them, Spy Fox. They may come in handy.
X-ray gum. How does this work, Professor Quack?
Ah, that's my new and improved beef flavor X-ray gum. I'll explain how it works. You take a stick out, put it up against something beefy, move it around, and then you can see the yucky stuff inside. The best part of all is, when you're done, you can chew the gum. It actually has a very refreshing, beefy flavor.
You know, 4 out of 5 dentists prefer X-ray gum for their patients who need X-rays.
A duck needs his fiber.
Hmm. Now, if you don't mind, Mr. Udderly, I'm going to need to use this X-ray gum to take a look at those four stomachs of yours.
This isn't going to hurt, is it? Because I get kind of dizzy when I think about pain. In fact, just saying the word pain makes me want to...
Professor Quack, your X-ray gum works perfectly. I can see everything inside Mr. Udderly's gut. His ticker looks like it needs winding. If I had a wrench in me, I would retch. I found the note. I'll be able to disarm that milky weapon of destruction with that punch card. I just need to find it, then figure out where to place it. Nothing like recycling. Good for the spy business, good for the environment. What's in this egg-shaped container, Professor Quack?
This is a little gadget I call the spy putty. What you do is open the cute little egg container and spread the putty on whatever you want to make a copy of. Press down, and then peel the putty off. You have a perfect copy.
That looks rather silly.
I know what you're thinking. You think that the spy putty looks a lot like that silly stuff they sell in toy stores. What you don't know is that I thought of it first. Those duplicitous duplicators stole my idea.
It looks like a delicious snack. May I eat this, Professor Quack?
Okay, that's the cheese and safe cracker kit. It will help you to get into almost any safe in the world. I won't explain exactly how it works, because it's very scientific and complicated. Trust me when I say it works like a charm.
And it tastes great in soup.
Yeah, and this paper isn't half bad.
Is this coin really a spy gadget, Professor Quack?
Ah, that's the spy trap. Let me explain how it works. It looks like an ordinary coin, like you might find in the street. But if you need to trap three or more bad guys, the coin explodes and a net shoots out. It traps the naughty spy enemies. Nice, huh?
Heads I win, tails they lose.
I'm going to lose my appetite if I keep this on.
Hey, according to Spy Corps' database, William the Kid has three overdue library books.
I always suspected Kid had some latent criminal tendencies. I'll keep my extraordinarily sharp eyes open for clues, so I can find Kid's secret fortress.
Welcome to the Trinket Emporium. My name is Gilbert. How may I be of service to you, O honorable visitor, to this, our dear island home?
I'm not sure yet. I was just noticing your fine selection of trinkets.
Sir, I think that you will find we offer much more than mere trinkets. We pride ourselves in having the island's finest selection of rare and hard-to-find collector items and antiquities.
Excellent. One never knows when they will be struck with an unquenchable desire to indulge in a blatant act of bourgeois consumerism.
Our thoughts exactly, sir.
What could anyone possibly do with a whole jar of trinkets?
It could be a paperweight. You could make a unique lamp out of it. It could be turned on its side to roll out cookie dough. There must be a million and one uses.
So, what's a jar of trinkets going for these days?
Normally, sir, they're 20 drachmas, but for you, how about 50?
Sounds good to me. I'll take it.
There you go, sir.
Why, thank you. There's no telling when I might need one of these hats. You'd better give me 40 of them.
40? But I only have one left.
All right, I'll take one of them.
Good. I hope you and your little hat will be happy together. Have a nice day.
So, Captain, do you think you could take me out for a little boat ride?
I'd love to, but there's just one problem. I can't go anywhere without my lucky charm.
Your lucky charm?
Aye, matey. Because that there is the sea, the final frontier. And my voyages on the SS Winterprise. On a 25-year mission to seek out new sea life and new civilizations, I boldly went where no raccoon has gone before. But without my lucky charm, it would be way too risky. I can't chance it.
I can gather information about Captain Drydock and his lucky charm with this.
Pardon me, sir, but just where do you think you're going?
On board.
Sir, you are obviously making a little joke. No one but no one is allowed to go on board the SS Deadweight without a gold-edged, wax-sealed, expensively embossed, handwritten invitation. And do you have one of these, sir?
Not as such.
Then I'm afraid, sir, that you should make like a plane in the Bermuda Triangle and get lost.
I can gather information about the deck party with this. What do you know about Captain Drydock and his missing lucky charm?
Oh, please. Can't you see I have official business to attend to? This is the sort of riffraff behavior I associate with that wretched cantina in town.
The cantina, eh? I'll keep that in mind. What can you tell me about the doorman over there? He's a real stickler for an invitation, isn't he?
Ah! Yes, he's amongst Russian Blue's favorite employees, I suspect.
If I could only get past him and into that deck party. Do you know anything about the lucky charm poor Captain Drydock lost?
I know nothing of any importance pertaining to this supposed lucky charm of which you speak, sir. I know that Drydock spends a lot of time in the cantina, however.
Great, thanks. I noticed that there was a party going on down on that big ship at the docks. But I understand you can only go if you were invited.
That is true. In fact, I am going as soon as I get off work.
Oh, so you got an invitation.
I certainly did. It is really a fancy schmancy one, too. Would you like to look at it?
Why, yes. I would love to look at it. I'm so impressed that you got an invitation to this fancy deck party. Will you be wearing your tuxedo?
No, I have chosen one of my finest all-cotton t-shirts to wear. One that will show off my impressive pectoral muscles.
I'm sure. I'd like to purchase that fine stuffed kitty.
All right, I'll get it for you. Here, kitty, kitty, kitty. Ah! 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 Oh, forget it. I can't sell you that cat. It's still alive. Meow. Did you hear that? Meow. There it was again.
Hi, honey. Welcome to the cantina. I'm Bee Bear. If there's anything I can get you, sugar, like, for example, sugar, You just let me know, all right?
Thanks, B.
Here's a number that goes out to all you white tux-wearing spies.
So, is the food here any good?
Well, between you and me, sweetie, let's just say it's no coincidence that you don't see any rats in this part of town.
What's the special of the day, Bee?
Thursday's special is macrame and cheese. But we're out of real cheese, so it's macrame with some yellow-colored paste. What do you think?
I think not. Macrame and cheese, eh? So what's the macrame made with?
Pasta. But the real question is, what is made with the macrame? You should see some of the potholders the cook has going in the kitchen.
Chicken knuckles to go. Those look interesting.
Honey, they're so bad. We're required by law to serve them to go. After you eat some, you have to go. If you know what I mean.
Beet bliss. It smells funny. Secret sauce. May cause drowsiness in alligators. Why don't you give me one order of chicken knuckles to go?
It's your funeral, honey.
It says secret sauce. Do I dare be?
You tell me, spy guy.
Greetings. Interested in a little game of Go Fish, Mr.
Fox? Spy Fox. I've been known to play Go Fish from time to time, and you are?
Artemus J. Big Pig. Pleased to make your acquaintance, sir. What do you say we make this game a little more interesting? Would you care to play for some trinkets?
I just happen to have a whole jar of trinkets.
Excellent, then. I like a fox who is willing to play for trinkets with a pig who likes to play Go Fish for trinkets. Place your trinkets on the table and we'll get started.
What do you know about Captain Drydock and his missing lucky charm?
Poor sap lost it in a particularly tense game of Go Fish.
Oh, really? So this is the lucky charm, then?
Yes, and I won't give it up easily. And you know that Go Fish is my game.
Why don't we really raise the stakes on this game and play for Captain Drydock's lucky charm?
Very well, sir, if you insist.
Got any aces?
No fish, sir. Got any sixes?
Nice try, but you need to go fish. Got any kings? What a fun game this is. Got any queens? What a fun game this is. Got any tens?
No, sir. Go fish. Got any nines?
Go fish. Got any fives?
Not a one, sir. Go fish. Got any jacks?
Go fish. Got any threes?
Go fish, Mr. Fox. Got any kings? Got any twos?
Nope. Go fish. Got any fours?
Go fish. Got any aces? Got any jacks?
Nice try, but you need to go fish. Got any sevens?
Go fish, Mr. Fox. Got any nines?
Go fish. Got any jacks? What a fun game this is. Got any tens?
Go fish, sir. Got any kings?
Nice try, but you need to go fish. Got any nines? I'll just take those off your hands. I love this game. Got any queens?
Not a one, sir. Go fish. Got any twos?
Nope. Go fish.
got any fives?
No, sir. Go fish.
I've always been lucky when it comes to go fish. Got any fours? Got any eights?
Go fish. Got any sixes?
Nice try, but you need to go fish.
I hope you are not easily discouraged, sir.
Got any jacks?
No, sir. Go fish.
Got any queens?
Not a one, sir. Go fish. Got any kings?
I thought you said you were good at this game. Go fish. Got any tens?
Go fish, Mr. Fox. Got any fives? Ah, how delightful. That gives me a suit, sir. Got any twos?
Go fish.
And that makes a set, sir.
Got any sevens?
Go fish. Got any kings?
Nope. Go fish. Got any jacks?
Go fish, sir. Got any fours? Yes, I'm good. Got any twos? Got any kings?
Go fish. Got any tens?
Go fish. Got any jacks? Ah, yes. Another one for me, sir. Got any twos?
Nice try, but you need to go fish.
A match made in heaven, sir.
Got any queens?
Go fish, sir.
I've always been lucky when it comes to go fish.
Got any twos?
Nice try, but you need to go fish. Got any queens?
No, sir. Go fish. Got any eights? Got any twos?
Nice try, but you need to go fish. Got any sevens?
Go fish, Mr. Fox. Got any queens? I must apologize, sir. I am rather good at this game. Got any eights?
Nice try, but you need to go fish. Got any twos? I'll just take those off your hands. That's one set of cards taken care of. Got any sevens?
Not a one, sir. Go fish. Got any threes? Ah, how delightful. That gives me a suit, sir. Got any eights? And that makes a set, sir. I win. Can I interest you in another game, Mr. Fox? Put another trinket on the table to begin.
So, you like playing for trinkets, eh? All right, I'm game. Here's my trinket. Let's play.
That's a lovely trinket you have there, sir.
Got any jacks?
Go fish. Got any sevens? Got any aces?
Go fish. Got any sixes?
Not a one, sir. Go fish. Got any sevens?
Go fish. Got any fives? Got any nines?
No, sir. Go fish. Got any threes?
Nope. Go fish. Got any tens?
Go fish, Mr. Fox. Got any fours? Got any threes?
Go fish. Got any kings?
Go fish, sir. Got any queens?
Nice try, but you need to go fish.
Got any fives?
Go fish, Mr. Fox. Got any fours?
Go fish. Got any threes? I'll just take those off your hands. This suits me just fine. Got any twos?
No, sir. Go fish. Got any kings? Got any nines? Got any aces? Ah, yes. Got any queens?
Nope. Go fish. Got any jacks?
Go fish.
Got any tens? What a fun game this is. Got any twos?
Go fish, sir. Got any fours?
Nice try, but you need to go fish. Got any fives?
Not a one, sir. Go fish.
Got any twos?
Go fish. Got any sevens?
Go fish. Got any queens? A card. Thank you so much. Got any sixes? Got any twos?
No, sir. Go fish. Got any kings?
Go fish. Got any sixes?
Go fish, Mr. Fox.
That's one set of cards taken care of. Got any fives?
Not a one, sir. Go fish.
I love this game.
Got any jacks? Got any sevens?
Nope. Go fish. Got any twos?
Go fish, sir.
This suits me just fine.
Got any jacks?
Nice try, but you need to go fish.
Yes, I'm good.
Got any tens?
Go fish, Mr. Fox. Got any sevens?
Nice try, but you need to go fish. Got any twos?
Go fish, sir. Got any eights? Got any jacks?
Nope. Go fish. Got any sevens? Got any twos?
Not a one, sir. Go fish.
I've always been lucky when it comes to go fish. Got any tens? What a fun game this is. Got any sevens?
Go fish. Got any eights?
I thought you said you were good at this game. Go fish. Got any jacks? I'll just take those off your hands. That's one set of cards taken care of. Got any sevens? A card. Thank you so much. I've always been lucky when it comes to go fish. Got any tens?
No, sir. Go fish.
This suits me just fine. I win!
All right, so you won the captain's lucky charm back. Ask yourself, sir, if the charm is so lucky, why did I lose it?
Because I'm a superior go fish player, that's why.
Gads, I like you, sir. Whenever you want to play go fish again with a go fish playing pig, I'm ready and waiting.
So, Captain Drydock, I just had an interesting little game of go fish with that Mr. Big Pig at the cantina. And you'll never guess what happened.
He cheated and ended up winning your lucky charm.
No, actually, he lost and I won this.
My lucky charm, you found it, yes. Do you know what this means? I can go out on the sea again. The curse is lifted, thank you. Thank you.
Charmed, I'm sure.
Listen, matey, if you ever need to use the SS Winterprise, Just let me know. I'll take you anywhere you need to go.
Not you again! How many times do I have to tell you? This is a private party, and without an invitation, you are not allowed to go on board. Sheesh! The nerve of some people. You'd think they would. Yay! Let me see that. Signed, Russian Blue. Oh, sir, we are ever so honored to have you on board with us today. Please, feel free to come and go as you wish.
Why, thank you. How gracious of you. What a weasel.
I trust you will have an enjoyable visit. And if there is any way in which I can kiss up some more, sir, I trust you will let me know.
But of course. So, this is the deck party. Before I join the festivities, I should let Monkey Penny know I'm here. Spy Fox to Mobile Command Center.
Please stand by.
Hi, Spy Fox. How's the mission progressing?
I just made it onto the SS Deadweight. I'm going to take a look around.
Good. Keep your eyes peeled for clues as to where William the Kid's secret fortress is.
If Kid's fortress is so secret, how come we know about it?
We're spies, Spy Fox. It's our job to know.
And we are good at our jobs. Spy Fox out. I have to say, you certainly have a unique conducting style.
Thank you, sir. It runs in my family. My father was a train conductor. Now, if you don't mind, I'm a very busy.
Hi there. You must be my replacement. Listen, you'd better show up to relieve me as soon as that clock strikes four bells and a hiccup. I really have to go, if you know what I mean.
Don't worry. You have to keep a dry sense of humor about these things. I'll be back. I can gather information about the sailor watchman on the SS Deadweight with this. What do you know about the sailor up on the SS Deadweight Bridge?
All I know is that he dashes off the ship as soon as his shift ends. I've heard him muttering about happy hour.
Happy hour at the cantina, no doubt. What do you know about this sailor from the SS Deadweight?
Oh, that Sal comes in every day straight from work.
What time is that?
He shows up here 38 minutes after the start of happy hour.
That's a frog suit. Ideal for any amphibious occasion. A frog suit like this might come in handy, especially considering the worldwide dairy crisis at hand. Interesting. This seems to be some sort of a high-tech alarm clock. This could be helpful. After all, they say timing is everything. That's it. That's the sound the sailor told me indicates the end of his shift. Okay, you can go now.
Thank you. Out of my way. Coming through.
When you gotta go, you gotta go. that's curious. The SS Deadweight made an unscheduled stop out in the middle of the ocean. This particular spot could require some further investigation. Let's see. It looks like the SS Deadweight went to 10 degrees latitude, 100 degrees longitude.
Can't resist the call of the sea, can ya? Even when it calls, collect. Let me grab my map and you can show me where you'd like to go.
Let's try here.
Darn the torpedoes, full speed ahead. I'll just keep the map here in case we need it later.
Interesting, a pool of white water. I've never seen white water like this before. Wait a minute, it's milk, dairy milk, and none too fresh, I might add. It sounds just like a seashell out here. Now I'm a lean, green swimming machine. Ah, yes, the underwater splendor of the Mediterranean.
Alas, poor Yorick. I knew him, Horatio.
Aha! That pipe must be where all the milk is coming from. What a terrible waste. I have to put a stop to this. I guess worms have a bit of frogophobia. Oh well, a fishing line like this could come in handy. I can't go now. It looks like the other guard is coming back. Here goes. It's the dreaded Rear Admiral, also known as Spy Maneuver Number 41.
Oh. Huh? We must hook the big one.
That fisherman will have quite a fish story to tell. Yes, these worms are definitely frogophobic. I hate to be the bearer of an underwater wedgie, but I've run out of options.
Excuse me.
Whoa!
Gad!
I learned that one at spy camp. Ah, those were the days. A box of old airplane fuses. I'd hate to refuse a find like this. The seat's missing. Maybe the pilot used it as a flotation device. Here's the jet's fuse panel, and there are some missing pieces. These spare fuses must fit into the panel, but where? I wonder if this fuse panel is familiar to this fuse. Teach him for not leaving a key under the welcome mat. Mm-hmm. I guess that guided missile was misguided. Of course, I planned that. I love a dramatic pause before blowing up giant steel doors leading to secret fortresses. I think I've discovered the entrance to William the Kid's secret fortress. Spy Fox to Mobile Command Center.
Please stand by.
Hello, Monkey. What's up?
Spy Fox. If I've told you once, I've told you a million times. It's Monkey Penny.
Sorry. What do you want? I'm busy saving the world right now.
Our informant, Mata Hari, has some important information for you.
Where can I find Mata Hari?
I'm not sure. All she said is that she's underwater and you'll treasure her disguise.
Okay, I'll check it out. Spy Fox out.
Welcome to William the Kid's secret volcano fortress. Please insert the electronic code box and answer today's passcode phrase.
The spy wanted to counter the remark with intelligence?
That is not a valid response. Have a nice day.
Answering that code phrase looks like it might end up being punishing.
The boat will sink at midnight.
It looks like it already sunk to me.
That's not the correct code phrase.
I know, but it's the truth.
Agent Fox, it's good to be working with you again.
Mata Hari, what a fortunate surprise. What invaluable information nugget do you have for me?
I intercepted this nectar of the goats thing, but I don't know what it is. It looks like it fits into some larger component. Can you use it?
Are you kidding? I'll treasure this.
Well, I gotta go. Go fishing, Agent Fox.
Thanks for always sticking your neck out for me, Mata. You're a gem. Looks like the electronic code box plugs into the panel of this voice-activated security system.
Welcome to William the Kid's secret volcano fortress. The radio repairman was ecstatic about his job. This is correct. You may now enter the fortress at will. Have an even better day.
Thank you. What a polite voice box. I'd better let Monkey Penny know I made it inside Kid's secret fortress. Spy Fox to Mobile Command Center.
Please stand by.
Spy Fox, I'm glad you checked in. How's it going?
Smooth as sandpaper underpants. I just got into Kid's secret fortress.
Excellent. Now you've got to disarm that milky weapon of destruction.
I'm in there like swimwear. Spy Fox out. That thing is not only giving me the eye, it gave me the boot. I'd better look for a uniform. Interesting. This looks like some sort of locker room for kids' evil minions. It's a secret passageway. What a clever secret entrance. William the Kid can go from the town square to his secret fortress anytime he wants. I'd better leave this door unlocked in case I need to get back in here later.
Okay, all ashore, that's going ashore. Alrighty then, we're on our way.
Thanks for letting me leave my frog suit on your boat, Captain Drydock. A yellow jumpsuit. I'll bet this is the official Nectar of the Goats uniform. No one would recognize me in one of these. This Nectar of the Goats jumpsuit might be just the thing I need to get the jump on William the Kid. Uh-oh, someone's coming. I'd better hide. So that's the dastardly William the Kid that everyone's so worked up about.
Ms. Blue, take this piece of paper from the easel in my office. It has the location of the punch card written on it. You must destroy it. That punch card is the only thing that can disarm the Milky Weapon of Destruction now.
Right away, your Imperial Goatness.
I've deposited the money in your bank account. Thanks for all your help.
It's a pleasure doing business with you. Call me anytime.
I need to get my hands on that punch card he mentioned. Maybe I can use these conveyor belts to get up to that platform. Ouch! This is going to be more difficult than it looks. This looks exactly like that diagram over in the locker room. Now I need to move these levers to the positions shown in the diagram. This must be some sort of tram to take people around in Kid's Fortress. Hot butter! There's Kid's giant milk carton. How fresh can all that milk be by now? William the Kid is deranged. The sight of Kid's diabolical milk carton curdles my stomach. He must be stopped. It looks like a billboard. Those guards are in ready position. I wonder what they're guarding.
Hey! Where do you think you're going?
Oh, hi. I'm from the accounting office. I was asked to count all the offices. I need to get into that room and make sure it's really an office.
If you're from the accounting office, you know perfectly well that this is William the Kid's office. No one but the Grand Goathead himself is allowed in there.
Oh, right. Of course. How silly of me. That's the office that really counts. Sorry to bother you. I need to get into Kid's office and take a look around. There's one sound the ear can hear better than any others. The sound of falling money. They should get a tickle from this nickel. Thank you.
trapped! He tricked us! This isn't good at all! Run us down from here!
Sorry, folks. I'm on a mission.
You must be one dedicated accountant! Seriously, you've got to let us go! I just know our supervisor is going to bring this up in our annual review!
I'm afraid you'll be hanging out there for a while.
Listen, buddy! I'm starting to get a cramp! Couldn't you just loosen the net a bit?
No can do.
Hey, are you really from the accounting office?
I wouldn't count on it.
William the Kid will force us to eat moldy cheese for a week if he catches us like this! You just got to cut us loose!
You should be careful who you choose to work for. Oh, this must be Kid's secret volcano office. I should take a look around. This must be the paper William the Kid mentioned. Now, can I get the location of that punch card? It says yellow. Somehow, I don't think William the Kid was thinking of the chalk when he wrote that. It would be silly not to snoop around Kid's office. I'll come back here later. I've been itching to take this jumpsuit off. I think whomever this belonged to had fleas. Grande fromaggio? Oh, right. Italian for the big cheese. How droll. Interesting. Clothed goat descending staircase. This seems to be some sort of multicolored lock mechanism. Aha! A secret wall safe! What an original hiding place! This cheese and safe cracker kit should do the trick. Okay, now for the tricky part. This seems to be working. One more to go. I'm in! Sometimes I amaze even myself. Those must be the punch cards. Which one do I need? Maybe this is the lucky punch card. I'd better close the safe. I don't want anyone to suspect that it's been tampered with. I guess every hero needs a uniform. This just isn't the one I pictured myself in. This must be where William the Kid keeps his controls for the milky weapon of destruction. I should let Monkey Penny know I've made it here. Spy Fox to Mobile Command Center.
Please stand by.
Spy Fox, good to hear from you. What's up?
I'm in William the Kid's control room. The launching panel for the Milky Weapon of Destruction is right here.
Great.
Spy Fox out. I hope this is the right punch card. That did the trick. Once again, I've saved the world from a horrible, or in this case, smelly, fate. Now I need to go get that goat.
Not so fast, my crafty friend. You may think you have outfoxed me by disarming my milky weapon of destruction, but I'm afraid it's too late to save your precious cows.
It's over, Billy. Give yourself up.
Don't ever call me Billy.
It's William.
And it's not over yet, my foxy nemesis. When I pull this lovely lever, the cow stables will become completely flooded with milk. And that will be the end of the dairy world as we know it.
That's the most despicable thing I've ever seen.
Man, this is really rich.
Kid, you're kidding yourself if you think I'm going to let you get away with this.
It's too late. And now, if you'll excuse me, Mr. Fox, I have a flight to catch on my giant metallic getaway blimp, where I will implement my plan to take over the world, filling it with my delicious goat byproducts.
Delicious? You must be insane.
Insane, you say? You're the crazy one, if you think you can save the cows.
Adios, Mr. Fox.
And good luck finding this secret passageway to the stables.
You'll need it.
Stupid door.
Thanks for leaving a little clue, kid. Now, all I have to do is find that ascot. That's Kid's ascot. This must be the secret passageway to the stables where Kid is holding the cows. I'd better hurry. This should be easy. Uh-oh. I can't swim past these alligators. They're looking at me like I'm bait. Tempting the alligators with some chicken knuckles might be just... I never knew alligators like chicken knuckles. Maybe they'll eat enough to need a nice nap afterwards. All right, let's see how the chicken knuckles, seasoned with secret sauce, affect the gators. Hey! The secret sauce is putting them to sleep! An alligator skin bridge. See you later, alligator. The kidnapped dairy cows. I found them. Hang on, everyone. My name is Spy Fox, and I'll rescue you shortly. Continue treading milk, and I'll be right there. I hereby declare you free-range cows.
But you're wrong. Go ahead, free the cows this time. But I'll be back to milk the world yet again.
Not so fast, kid. The last thing the world needs is another escaped goat. Think fast, Fox. This road ends just ahead. This'll eject me right onto Kid's blimp. Yeah. Now that was an entrance. I'd better check in with Monkey Penny. Spy Fox to Mobile Command Center.
Please stand by.
Spy Fox, have you found William the Kid yet?
I'm on his escape blimp now.
Professor Quack says he can see you on the radar. Spy Fox, you can't let William the Kid get away.
But what about the sequel?
There are other supervillains out there. We'll be fine.
That's true. What should I do when I nab him?
We've already set up a mobile evil villain jail.
Monkey Penny, do you have the coordinates for the evil villain jail?
Yes. The coordinates are 10 degrees south, 20 degrees west. You need to fly the blimp over it. I'll transmit the coordinates to the spy watch in case you need to look at them again.
Now I need to maneuver this ghastly blimp to that location. I'll get that dastardly villain. This reminds me of my high-flying days in the Spy Air Corps. That must be the entrance to the front of Kid's diabolical blimp. Must be the control room for Kid's diabolical getaway blimp.
Now I can begin working on my worldwide dairy domination plan B. It took me years to perfect that evil laugh.
A navigation panel. Now I can use the coordinates Monkey Penny sent me via the spy watch to maneuver this dastardly contraption over the evil villain jail. Then I can finally put William the Kid where he belongs. Now I just need to find a way to get Kid out of this blimp and into evil villain jail. This will take me to the back of the blimp. Looks like someone didn't finish their lunch. Well, you never know when you might need a piece of stale rye bread. An electric screwdriver set. This could come in handy. You never know when you might need to drive some screws somewhere. Aha! The ejection seat controls must be here. I can finally throw Kid into evil villain jail. That did the trick. Hmm, what an interesting device. It's just like the toaster we have back at Spy Corps cafeteria. A piece of rye bread might do the trick. My trap is set. I'd better hurry.
What's going on? The blimp is changing course.
Sorry, kid. I have a little errand I need to run.
What? Spy Fox? I'm really getting tired of your meddling in my dairy domination plans.
Yes, well, I do have a tendency to show up and ruin evil villains' schemes. I just thought I'd toast your accomplishment before you go.
Go? What do you mean by that? Whoa!
Too bad, there was only one parachute.
Ooh,
that looked painful. I guess Kid will be serving up his goat byproducts in evil villain jail from now on.
I would have gotten away with my dear plan. For that pesky spy fox. Spy fox! You'll pay for this. I'll be back. No jail can hold William the Kid.
Later that day,
Walter Wireless here with our top story. Spy Fox has saved the dairy starved nations of the world from a near disastrous milk shortage. Today at the Capitol, the president is honoring Spy Fox as the nation's new hero. We now go live to the presidential press room where the ceremony is already in progress.
For outstanding heroism and suaveness in the face of utter dairy chaos, and for bringing the nefarious William the Kid to justice, I award you, Spy Fox, our nation's highest honor. May I present you with the Big Daddy Congressional Cookie of Justice.
Why, thank you, Mr. President. It was a routine mission, really.
Three cheers for Spy Fox.
I've got my cookie. Has anyone got milk?
Would have gotten away with my evil plan if it weren't for that pesky spy fox.
I would have gotten away with my evil plan if it weren't for that pesky spy fox.